This video is sponsored by the brand new JV Jiu-Jitsu online store at jvjiu-jitsu.bigcartel.com. What's going on, everybody? This is Javi Vasquez. Control is a primary focus throughout the entire master plan system, and leg locks are no different. Just like with any other position, if control cannot be achieved, it will be incredibly difficult to submit your opponent. Preventing an opponent from turning while in a leg entanglement is crucial to establishing the position as well as completing the break. In this video, I will discuss how to prevent an opponent from turning. Putting downward pressure over an opponent's hips with your legs or foot is one of the most effective ways to prevent an opponent from turning their body or rotating their knee out of the hole. As always, I hope you enjoy this content and thank you for watching.
I'm saying for the most part. So again, what are the three control points?
Foot, knee, thigh.
Hip. Foot, knee, hip. Now, I like to play this position because it's two against one, right? So I always want to be, if for me to try to submit this leg, it's going to be hard. Not impossible, but hard. Because I have less control on this leg than I do on this one. Does that make sense? So I figured out how to control at the foot. I also figured out how to control at the knee by either being here or being here. I'll hold it this way here. So if he tries to pull away, it gives me just that additional control by holding at the knee. So how do I hold now at the hip? Okay? Well, generally, the way this guy is going to escape is a couple different ways. One way is he's going to use his foot to push me away and then slide his leg out. His leg has to be, for the most part, pretty straight so that it can come like a key, straight in and out of the lock, right? Right? Pull it out, he pushes, and goes. Perfect. Rotation is another way that he can go, because if he starts to twist his knee, pop the heel out first. The heel comes out, pull it, the foot comes out. Say, for example, I'm doing this here. What he wants to do is he wants to roll. So realistically, he wants to take his knee from the inside of my lap and put it on the outside by putting it on the ground behind my hamstring. Go. Pull, pull, pull. And the knee comes out this way. Okay? So rotation is a problem. There's rotation at the knee, and then there's rotation at the hip. Now, how do I hold the hip? Now, a lot of times what you guys do is you guys will start to straighten. But if he tries to turn that hip, notice what happens. The hip actually comes up and then rotates over. You see this right here? This is the position. So go ahead and rotate over. Rotate over. What am I doing? I'm making my legs heavy. I'm elevating my hip turns. I'm driving my weight down. The reason my feet are coming off the ground is because he's able to turn some, but he's not able to rotate completely. So whether I'm here or here, right, I'm trying to hold him down, more so here. Now, if he tries to roll from this position, this is why my feet are here. If I scoop Nick, roll that way. Why can't you roll that way? It's going against his foot. So he's gonna roll this way here. So that's why my feet are here, to lace him and to trap him and prevent him from turning. Now, when you do this here where you're kicking over and under and you can kind of hold him here with both legs, wonderful. If I can hold him here with my hand as well, wonderful. I want to thread one, overhook and cross my feet here, he's really laced. And it's very entangled, and it takes a minute for him to get that out. In the meantime, I'm attacking his heel. So it's important that we just focus on, okay, he's turning. How do I stop him from turning? Control at the hip. So even if I'm like this, turn. See, I'm leaning and I'm pushing his hip down. You could also do it with the legs here. I'm elevating my hip, pushing his hip down, preventing him from turning. The more he turns that way, the more I turn this way. The counterweight gives me a lot of leverage because I'm controlling low at the foot. So what I want you to do right now is, let's just get to the X. And as he starts to roll over, I'm gonna elevate my, look, I keep my back in there, I elevate my hip. If he starts to turn, it is very likely that this other foot is gonna start pushing, so I'm going to start to elevate my hip and coming over his foot. And now I can start to bring him back down. Did you guys catch how I did that? Did you catch how I did that? So from here, I have my standard control where I'm holding him down. But sometimes they turn very aggressively. Now when he turns, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab his ankle and I'm gonna lift his leg and pull him into me. So now my hip is really deep in the hole. So he's gonna start to use his foot here on my butt. I'm gonna go up and over the foot and then bring him back down. So I'm kind of, as he's pushing me, I go up and over it and sit on top of that foot. So now he can't push anymore. Now he's gonna have to pull it out. And as he pulls it out, it gives me a chance to reset. The other thing I can do is if he's pushing that foot away, go ahead, push quickly away your foot, is try to pass the leg to the other side and then use your other hand to control the foot. The more you can control this other leg with your hands, the better off you're gonna be. He has a harder time defending if he doesn't have any legs to push off of, right? And turn. Now where do we land? So I switch my legs in transition. I might be saying too much. You guys are trying to confuse you. What I want you to take away from this portion right here is keep him from turning. Whether your legs are on the inside, turn this way. I'm gonna use my legs to be heavy, preventing the turn. If I'm here, turn, I'm using my legs, the extension and the hooking underneath his legs to prevent him from rolling that way over there. If his legs are here, you can still keep him from rolling. I'm controlling his knee. Go, roll, which way do you roll? This way here. If he goes that way there, I use my other foot to stop his hip. Whichever way he's going, there's got to be something giving counter pressure to hold it down. Questions? Questions? Hug the leg. Start with the X. Have him start to turn. Learn how to control him. Learn how to stop him from turning. Are you going to be able to stop him from turning every time? No, but at the very least, I need to understand how to kind of hold him down with your legs. Start from the X and then keep him from turning. Go.
Hey everybody, thank you so much for watching my video. Please click like and subscribe to my channel for more great strike-based jiu-jitsu content. If you have any questions about the techniques that I'm demonstrating, please leave a comment in the comment section below. Thank you so much.